M-Copa is a new Kenyan innovation and has brought the benefits of solar lighting to thousands of rural homes, enabling our children to study after school, relieving our mothers from the burden of fetching firewood and burning kerosene late into the night. These are just but a few examples that demonstrate the ability of this continent to transform challenges into opportunities. Mr. President, ladies and gentlemen, we are a resilient and brave people. You are all aware that nearly 2 years ago, the Westgate Mall in Nairobi was the scene of a heartbreaking act of criminal brutality. To the world, it became an emblem of extremist violence and terrorism. I am proud to inform you that a week ago, this mall reopened and its flagship store proceeded to record more sales on the first day of opening than on any other day in the mall's history. We were able to rise above our pain, and we resolved that we must keep marching forward. We are truly a nation that shames its saboteurs and detractors. Mr. President, the democratic space in Kenya was secured by a transformation in governance. Our people aspired for a new constitutional dispensation, which my government has implemented in both letter and spirit. In just 2 years, we have fully devolved government and brought services closer to the people. From the big cities of Nairobi and Mombasa, to the promising towns of Isiolo and Machakos, the impact of devolution means that no part of our country is left behind, and that national prosperity will be shared in every corner of our land. Mr. President, distinguished entrepreneurs, Africa is the world's newest and most promising frontier of limitless opportunity. Gone are the days when the only lens to view our continent was one of despair and indignity. Mr. President, Mr. President, this country and this continent does not claim perfection, but without a doubt, we can claim progress. The key insight is to see that we are at the beginning of a great journey, and it is a journey that we invite all of you to join us. We see, as clearly as anyone, that true opportunity demands the respect for human dignity, fundamental rights, and the protection of democratic ideals. These shared values are the bridge between the peoples of our different continents, cultures, and creeds. Mr. President, ladies and gentlemen, let me conclude by saying that aside from participating in this summit, I encourage all of you to go out and see for yourselves the enchanting beauty and promise of this country. You will without a doubt discover that Kenya is a hotbed of vibrant culture, spectacular natural beauty, a wonderful people, with infinite possibility. Let the world hear a very simple message, that the narrative of African despair and indignity is false, and indeed was never true. Mr. President, it is our hope that your presence here today, and indeed all of you gathered here, will help us change that narrative. When you go home, and indeed as you travel around the world, tell those who you meet about what you've seen here in Kenya. Share your experiences and let them know that Africa is open and ready for business. Yeah.